Now onwards from this video, we are going to start with the topic conversion of finite automata to a regular expression. That means from the given finite automata, we will find out the regular expression. You know that finite automata is for regular grammars only. So regular expressions can be derived from that given finite automata. So come, let's begin it. So let's learn how to find a regular expression that is represented by a finite automata. You know that every finite automata is only possible for regular expressions only. No other type of expression or grammar can be represented by finite automata. So if we are given a finite automata and we have to find out the regular expression that it is representing, then what is the procedure? Let's begin it. These are the three steps that you have to follow. The first step states, write the state equations. What are the state equations that I will tell you when we will do the practical example? Second, solve the equation of the final state. Out of the state equations that you have made, you will solve the equation of the final state only. Then the solution that you will get by solving the final state equation will be the required regular expression. But to follow these three steps, these are the two assumptions that you have to keep in mind. First, there should be only one initial state. In the finite automata, there cannot be more than one initial state. This you have to keep in mind. Second, there should be no null move. If there are null moves in your finite automata, first remove those null moves. In our previous lectures that I have taught you how to remove the null moves, please see them. So if these two assumptions are satisfied, then you can easily make the regular expression from the given finite automata. Let's do some examples now. So suppose, consider this example. This is the finite automata that is given to us and we have to find the regular expression. So the first step is we have to make the state equations. First initial state is Q naught. So consider Q naught first. The state equation of Q naught will be, you have to find out all the incoming edges. Incoming edges are, one is this, Q naught's edge is coming inwards to Q naught only with the input symbol A, and this edge is also incoming to the state Q naught. So the state equation for Q naught will be, Q naught is equals to Q naught A, multiply the input symbol with the state Q naught A, and this from Q1 with B. So plus Q1B. This is how we write the state equations. We see all the incoming edges and multiply that input symbol with that state symbol. So for the initial state, you have to keep in mind that this arrow is also incoming. We always mark this for initial state representation. So this is represented by null. We always represent the initial state with one arrow. So that arrow, that incoming edge will be represented by null, and all other incoming edges will be represented like this, Q0A and Q1B. Now state equation for Q1. Q1 is equals to, one incoming edge is from Q0, Q0A, plus one incoming edge with Q1 itself, Q1 with input symbol B, Q1B, and one is from Q2, Q2 with B, plus Q2B. Now state equation for Q2. Q2 has incoming edge, this one, from Q1, Q1 with A. So Q1A. This is the state equations for Q0, Q1 and Q2. Now out of these three state equations that we have made for the all three states, we have to solve the state equation of final state only. The final state is Q2, so we will solve only the state equation of Q2. Now let's see how do we do this. Now these are the three equations that we have made. So first label them. Label this as equation number 1, equation number 2 and equation number 3. Now I told you to solve the final state equation only. Q2 is our final state. So we will solve this. Q2 is equals to Q1A. Now to solve this, Q2 is equals to Q1A. Here it is written Q1. That means you need the value of Q1. So first we have to solve the Q1 equation also to substitute that Q1 in the place of this equation in Q2 is equals to Q1A. So let's solve the Q1 equation first. So let's solve the equation of Q1 then. Q1 is equals to Q0A plus Q1B plus q2b. This is our equation for q1. Now to solve this, as when you were solving the equation of q2, you needed q1 to substitute here. Now when you are solving for q1, you need q0 to substitute here and q2 to substitute here. Q1 is normal. In the state equation of q1, q1 can come, but q0 and q2 are problematic. So to substitute in place of q0 and q2, we have to solve this q0 also and q2 also. But wait, you can write it like this: q0a as it is, q1b as it is, but in place of q2 you can substitute from here q1a. Q1a is okay, because in the state equation of q1, q1 can come. So in place of this q2, you can substitute this q1a, and this b will be as it is. So this is the equation. Now you only need q0. Wait, we will substitute q0 also, but we can solve it further without substituting q0 even. So let's see, q0a plus, now from these two terms, q1b plus q1ab, you can take out this q1 common. Q1 here, b is left, plus, and here ab is left. Then here it is q1. Now if you substitute this q1 with r, let it be r, let it be capital Q, q0ab capital Q, in between plus, this q1 was, here we have taken q1 as r, so this is r, and take it as capital P. R is equals to q plus rp. This is the equation of Arden's theorem, and Arden's theorem said that if there are three regular expressions r, q and p, and if they are in the form r is equals to q plus rp, then there exists one unique solution. One unique solution was r is equals to qp closure. That means we can substitute this q plus rp with qp closure. So let's substitute it. R is equals to qp closure. R is q1. q1 is equals to q is q0a. P is b plus ab. And here it goes with closure, because it is qp closure. So we have got the equation of q1 as q1 is equals to q0a, b plus ab, closure. Note this equation and label it as equation number 4. So now in this equation, we need the value of q0. So now we will solve the equation of q0, then substitute q0 in this q1 equation, and then substitute this q1 here over q2, and finally we will get the equation of q2. So let's solve q0 now. So we have written the fourth equation here. Now we will solve the equation of q0 to substitute this q0 over here. Then we will finally get this equation of q1. So now as we have made a new simplified equation of q1, there is no need of this equation because we have simplified this only. So remove this equation. You can not consider this equation now. Consider this only, b plus ab closure. So let's solve for q0. q0 is equals to q0a plus q1b plus null. Now you have q1, substitute here q1, because q1 is having q0 term, we can substitute it because we are solving for q0 only. So q0a plus, in place of q1, write this whole q0a b plus ab closure, and this b will come here as it is, plus null. Now this is the equation. Now you can see that in these two terms, q0a and q0ab plus ab closure b, you can take out this q0 common. Take it out, q0. Here you are left with a, here you are left with a, and this whole b plus ab closure b. Q0 is outside, and here null is here. So now reverse that, write null here, and q0 a plus a b plus ab closure b, here it is q0. Consider this q0 as r, this null as q, plus this q naught is r and this whole is p. Then apply Arden's theorem. R is equals to q plus rp can be simplified as r is equals to qp closure. Okay, now r is q naught. Q naught is equals to q is null and p is this whole a plus a b plus a b closure b, and here p closure, so do here closure. So the state equation for q naught is now q naught is equals to null a plus a b plus a b closure b closure. So let's write it here. Q naught is equals to null a plus ab plus ab closure b, and here whole closure. You can rub this. Now there was one property of regular expression, null r closure gives you r closure. This is what the property of regular expressions. If you multiply, or you can write it like this, null into r gives r. When you multiply any regular expression with null, you get that regular expression only. That means this null into this regular expression will give us this regular expression directly, a plus a b plus a b closure b whole closure. So this is the final equation of q naught. Now you have solved for q naught, so you can substitute this q naught over here to get the value of q1. So q1 will be, substitute this whole q naught, a plus ab plus ab closure b whole closure, and here we have substituted this q naught. Now a is here, so write here a, then this b plus ab closure b plus AB closure. So this is the equation for Q naught. You substituted this Q naught over here, Q naught in place of this Q naught, you got the state equation for Q1. Now this is our Q1 equation. You can substitute this Q1 in this state equation of Q2 to get the equation of Q2. So Q2 is equals to, substitute full Q1 here from this value, A plus A B plus AB closure b whole closure a b plus a b closure. Till now we have substituted this q1 in this place. Now a is left, q2 is equals to q1 a, this is whole is q1, so multiply it with a because of this a. So this is the final equation for q2. As we have got the state equation for our, we have solved the solution for the state equation q2, which is our final state. So this is the required regular expression. So regular expression is a plus a b plus a b closure b whole closure a b plus a b closure a. This is our final required regular expression. I hope it is clear to you. We have to concentrate on the final state equation. In the final state equation, we needed q1. So we solved q1 first. While solving q1, we felt the need of q0. So we solved q0 first. On solving q0, we got this. We substituted this q0 over here and we got the final equation for q1. And when we got the final equation for q1, we substituted this value of q1 over here in the state equation of q2 and we got our regular expression. So concentrate only on the final state equation. Whatever this final state equation requires, you have to solve that, and finally substitution can help you get the regular expression. Let's consider one more example now. So I hope whatever procedure that I have taught you to convert a given finite automata to a regular expression is clear to you, and if you have any doubts, you can just drop an email at the email address that is mentioned in the description of the video. Please see the description of the video also, and if you liked our video, please hit the like button, please share it with your friends, and if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, please hit the subscribe button also. Thank you.